Welcome back. Then, as we speak, the Nifty is holding but good gains at this point of time with a gain of around 40 points. Mid-cap index showing a relative underperformance today, sitting with a gain of only around 0.2%. But the stock on our radar today is Sangam India. We're joined currently by Mr. Soni, the Joint President of Finance and the Corporate Relations at the company, who joins us. Hi, Mr. Soni. Thanks so much for joining in. The first part of this year has been fairly good, and in fact, the year on the whole for the stock has been splendid for your investors, 290% higher this year itself. A couple of questions. How is quarter three shaping out? And also, earlier you had told us that, in fact, 2,000 crores is in the offing in terms of top line. Are you sticking with that guidance? And from where exactly will this growth come from, the exports or domestic?
No, current year we are targeting a growth of around 10% from last year's turnover of 1,470 crores.
Correct.
And next 2-3 years we are planning to grow by 20-25%. So growth of this business is coming largely from the denim business, where we are expanded fourfold in last 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
And recently we launched our new ventures of B2C business called Seamless Garment. So we are targeting a good amount of revenue from the Seamless Garment itself.
Okay. Could you tell us the growth that you're seeing in exports? Because the recent growth seems to be fueled by your exports market. It currently contributes about 22%. How much are you focusing that exports contribution will be to your overall revenue, the export growth rate that you foresee?
See, our total around 23% revenue come from the exports market till last year.
Mm-hmm.
This year it is likely to reach to 30% because we had seen an exponential growth in the denim business, and denim business growth, if you see the September quarter result, our denim export has reached by 12-fold. It's a 12-fold growth which has happened in the denim exports business. Then in the PV fabric business, again, our export has grown by close to 30%.
Okay.
In yarn business also, our export is grown by around 20%. So it's overall export growth is there for the company.
All right. Mr. Soni, you know, the big positive definitely has been the margin expansion. I think the last time around we had a margin of around 15.5%. If you compare it on a year-on-year basis, that's a good 300 basis point or 250 basis point jump. Now, given that you're going to be shifting towards export focus, maybe around 30% approximately, you're saying things are looking good over there as well. What kind of an impact can it have on your margins going ahead? Do you see it expanding from around this 15.5%?
Yeah, I think we expect in next 2-3 years our margin should expand by 200 basis points from the current level.
Okay.
Looking at the export growth, and then we are consolidating our position in the company itself. We are converting more of the yarn into the fabric and in the value-added products. So more of the consolidation of the business is happening in the company itself. That is again giving expansion to our margins.
Okay. The promoters have been steadily increasing stake in the company. As of September, it stands at 47.35%. And in the two quarters prior to that, you've already increased it by about 3 to 4 percentage point. How much do the promoters want to increase their stake to? Would they be only okay with increasing it up to 5% as is allowed under the creeping acquisition route?
Yeah, we are right now increasing our stake through creeping only. And in last 3 years, we increased our stake by 9%. So basically, we wanted to reach in the 51% zone, which is a comfortable from the promoter's angle. So we are seeing the further opportunity. If opportunity is available, we can go by the creeping acquisition only.
So you'll stop at 51%? You want to increase it to 51%?
Yeah. As of now, we are targeting 51%. All thing is in the future scenario, so we cannot make comment as of now for that. But 51% is our target primary.
All right. So I think this year you'll not be able to do that because you've already done roughly around, you've done around 4.5%. So I think you'll only be doing it post March 2016.
Yes. It should be.
All right. Mr. Soni, also I want to ask you, what's your current debt in your books? I remember you had exited one of your other businesses that wasn't faring too well. And in fact, that was used, I think, the road toll collection business. You had exited that. What is your current debt that you have on your books?
Current debt on our books is around 250 crore is our long-term debt and 270 is our working capital debt. And this long-term debt is going to retire in next 3 years. So basically, whatever capex we are doing, we are maintaining our debt at the same ratio. In last 4 years, we consolidated our balance sheet and we have reached a debt equity level of 3.91, which was there in 2011 to 1.45 level, debt equity of 1.45 in the current financial year. And next 2-3 years, we are targeting that our debt equity should further improve to below 1.
Okay, Mr. Soni, we leave it at that. Thanks so much for joining in.